Pande, the lead analyst, IT and Telecom for Prabhudas Lilladher, are joining us. Aniket, good morning and welcome. Let's first talk about, now we know in the last 1 year, IT has been stellar performer. There has been a lot of news swings also, I should say again, where again we are talking about H-1B visas, again, how perhaps there is a slowdown, what could happen. So if I summarize everything, and if I want to ask you one question, firstly, what are the current headwinds which the IT sector is facing? And for those headwinds, which are the companies which could still tide through?
Okay. Hi. Thank you for having me. So we have recently released a report on IT sector. So, you know, like going forward, we have to see what are the differentiating factor in 2018 and 2019. So going, I mean CY 2018 and CY 2019. So going forward, we are seeing headwinds such as, there is a very strong headwind which is coming with a global slowdown. So you are seeing a US global slowdown which is going to happen. So there has been a softening of US yields, so which is going to impact the BFS spending of IT. Secondly, there are quite a pressure on supply sides right now. So supply side pressure are going to create constraints on the margin. So to focus on that, so IT companies will have to focus to many other measures to, right now the visa conditions are quite tight in US right now, and the unemployment rate is at a decade low right now. And due to the rising attrition in IT companies will have a tough job finding out to supply to force the demand.
Right. So, Aniket, then the question here is, in the context of, firstly, before I go and ask you more about the sort of growth parameters there, if there is a slowdown which could accelerate either in the European markets or perhaps in the Asian markets, US again still showing us some good numbers. Right. Is there something which you think is a concern for IT? Because the last time it happened, in fact, IT companies, they gained from it. So is there something which is a concern for the sector?
Yeah, so right now, yes, there is a concern, because right now, if you see, if you have to compare Indian IT companies with the US banking sector. So as I have mentioned before, the US top 10 year yield has been at decade low right now, and the US banks have this time mentioned that they are going to reduce spend on tech spend this time. So this is a time to be cautious on the IT sector, because most of the IT companies have their very high revenue exposure from the BFSI side. And right now in US, due to that, you can see reduction in tech spend happening. And as IT companies are moving into digital transformation right now, so digital technologies are getting matured right now. So for matured digital technology, you will require lateral employee base in US, which is quite tough to get in US right now, because the unemployment levels are extremely low in US right now. So the same thing is applied for Europe also. So Accenture and Cognizant have already cited their weakness in European geography in the last two quarters. So except TCS, all the IT companies have shown weakness in European geography. And as going forward in UC, so basically in FY17 and FY18, Europe was the major revenue driver for Indian IT sector and US was flat. So going forward, you see that, US right now, so I believe that there would be a good traction coming in US also and Europe also.
Okay, Aniket, then what will be your topics?
So basically my top pick in IT space currently in large cap is TCS only, and in mid cap I like LTTS.
Okay, and why you don't like L&T Infotech?
No, I like L&T Infotech also, but basically there is a lot of contraction in BFSI clients right now. So because of that, so actually in last 8 quarters, if you see LTI BFSI revenue growth has grown faster than its actual USD revenue growth. And in this last quarter also, they said that they are facing traction in BFSI account in US geography. So basically I like LTI as a company, and all its building blocks are placed really well. But going forward on that valuation, any traction in BFSI revenue growth in LTI can create a very big headwind for them.
Right, we asked this question again to get more sort of brief on the LTI, but let me say the targets which Aniket has. L&T Infotech, the target price is 1981, there's a buy rating, L&T Technology, target price is 1835. There is accumulate rating on that stock. Those all targets again right there on your screen. SL Tech, TCS again, those are again having a buy rating there. Target prices again are there on your screen. So that's a summary again which Aniket has. Aniket, one question to you. Looking at the sort of last two quarters have told us, TCS has outperformed almost in all sort of departments here. And then with the L&T Infotech, L&T Technologies, those actually were able to deliver some strong growth here. What's your own opinion now on the laggards, whether it's Infosys, SL Tech, Wipro? Again, how's the perception about those companies?
Yeah, so basically if you see Infosys, so in last quarter their maximum revenue contribution came from communication vertical only. So in Infosys in last quarter, around 79% of its revenue came from communication quarter. So in Infosys since last three quarters, we are seeing contraction in BFSI revenue growth. Okay, and if you see the attrition level in Infosys is at quite higher side right now. So Infosys attrition level is at 20% right now. So going on with the scenario in the US right now and the contraction of yields which we are seeing it. So basically we can see a ramp down in the BFSI spending. So that is not reflected in getting into IT spends right now, but going forward because of the contraction in BFSI spend, we can see a contraction happening in Infosys revenue also. So in spite of the deal win and the revenue acceleration is strong in Infosys, they are not able to accelerate their margin performance. So I am cautious on the margin trajectory on Infosys, and that's what keeps me cautious on Infosys going forward. And coming back to HCL Tech, so basically HCL Tech has done a lot of aggressive investment since last 2 years. So but they have been able to maintain their margin. So this time they have reduced their margin guidance. So basically now going forward, they will have to focus more on their product business, which is going to make a constraint on their margin profile. But if you see that there has been a steady growth in their organic revenue growth. So basically I believe that when HCL Tech is able to give strong organic revenue growth momentum, so that time you can see a re-rating of PE happening in HCL Tech. But I still remain, I have a buy rating on HCL Tech only based because I find the risk reward ratio, I find the risk reward ratio favorable for HCL Tech. So sure. I have given a modest PE of 14x to HCL Tech.
Okay, so that's the multiple. We'll ask another question in the context of what perhaps we should be making out of the IT companies. But before that, as Aniket was explaining us, what could be looking like. Aniket, a flavor on the June quarter so far, the trends in the context of deals announced or deals pending, what you're hearing. How's the June quarter broadly coming out for the industry?
Yeah, so basically in June quarter, you will see margin contraction almost in all the IT companies because I think this time IT companies will not get INR tailwind again and again in June quarter there would be an effective visa cost and wage hike. So basically you can see revenue acceleration happening in June quarter, but again there would be margin contraction happening in June quarter. So that will again create a pressure on the multiple re-rating of IT sector.
Okay, and what about the sort of wage revisions or currency swings? Out of these two factors, which normally are prominent factors for June quarter, is there anything which you think could be a headwind this time?
This time, I think the headwind would again come from the BFSI revenue traction from the IT companies. Because going forward, as we see that, if you see the US tech banking results also, Morgan Stanley, Credit Suisse, all have posted very bad numbers since last two quarters. So I believe that there would be a revenue traction, and due to the US global, due to the US 10-year yields falling down below a decade level, and US PMI index has also fallen down. So I think there would be a contraction in BFSI revenue also in this quarter, which would be again major de-rating factor for Indian IT stocks.
Aniket, let me try it out again because you talked about large caps. If it's possible, in the mid cap IT, anything major improvement, or if you actually are seeing any major change in sentiments on any of the mid cap IT stock, which is now coming as a topic for you?
Mid-cap IT, we like LTTS as a topic because we believe that LTTS is in a very sweet spot for its growth. So LTTS is having a very good revenue contribution and it's well distributed and it's well distributed among its all vertical. And in spite of a revenue, in spite of a client traction, so LTTS has given a very strong revenue growth of 14% to 16% for the next year. So I believe that with a stable margin profile and with a strong revenue growth, so I believe that LTTS would play out well.
Aniket, question. Usually we also look at the diversified nature of the large cap IT companies, and again then we call out the growth here. But if you wanted to pick out any one segment, could be communication, could be life science, could be the insurance, or could be the broader BFS space. Is there any one particular segment which you think is looking extremely strong, and that's one segment we should be really using for differentiating IT companies?
So I believe that 2 quarters back, communication was looking very strong for Indian IT companies actually. So you say like TechM has around 40% of its revenue contribution for communication sector. So communication sector was looking very strong 2 quarters back, but due to this recent global trade wars between US and Huawei. So again, there has been a, so again, I believe there would be delay in the decision making in the communication sector globally. Okay. So I used to like communication sector way back. But I think right now, presently, none of the sectors in IT, so none of the verticals in IT are looking strong presently. So I believe I believe weakness will prevail in BFSI also and in retail sector also.
Okay, and that's something interesting. The segments are sometimes very, very important. If you talk about insurance, Majesco sometimes comes into fair. Communication, as Aniket is saying, Tech Mahindra comes the 4 years. So segments sometimes they become a differentiating factor, so again watch out for that. But Aniket, thanks a lot for coming on the show and giving us all the insights into the IT sector.